Girl, it is so much going on, but I ain't got nothing to do with it.
It's a whole lot of going on. It's a lot of going on. It's a whole lot of going on. It's a lot of going on.
It's Monday, and you know what that mean. If it ain't about me, then I'm a Kiki. First on the docket, and I'ma talk shit. Got my sugar, honey, iced tea. Do you wanna sip now, period? I said what I said. Now move along, bitch, before you get red. P.O.P., you can't stick with me. Come on, girls, let's get
that messy Monday.
Lot of going on, it's a whole lot of going on, it's a whole lot of going on, it's a whole lot of going on.
Hey creeps, and welcome back to Messy Monday. As you already know, you can't sit with me unless you are POP, and that is pretty on purpose. How you doing? So this past week, I have to say, was like so many emotions. It was anger, it was confusion, it was hurt, it was joyful. It was a whole lot of different emotions. And the one emotion that I think struck everybody so much, besides the election, would have to be the King Von situation. I know that King Von has been on Messy Monday several times. I just want to take time out to say that I do believe King Von was an amazing person. I do believe he had a big heart. And I just want to take the time to celebrate the life that he lived on this earth, the people that he touched, the music he created, and just everything, the father that he was to his children, the son, the brother, the best friend, the boyfriend, just all that he was to people. Yes, so a moment of silence for King Von.
26-year-old Devon Bennett, also known as rapper King Von, shot and killed after a deadly fight erupted in front of Monaco Hookah Lounge.
Be mad, niggas don't like niggas, niggas be tweaking. It be all type of shit going on, and niggas don't know no other way to solve, resolve. Niggas don't know how to talk to each other. Niggas don't know how to come to a table or talk to, you know what I'm saying?
On some real
niggas
shit.
Niggas just gonna fuck it, you see what I'm saying? Right. Niggas ain't gonna talk about that. Nah, somebody killed somebody, everybody got family, somebody relate to him or somebody cool with him, you kill him. Now everybody that he was close with is trying to kill you. It's a never ending. Or they gonna kill, let's kill somebody close to him.
Right. Hey, how does that end? How y'all stop that?
It don't stop until everybody, all the people that playing the game, is gone. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's the last man standing. It's either you're going to be in jail, you're going to die, or you getting lucky around this bitch.
I'm Big Twin. That's Lil Twin.
Best stop playing. Best stop playing with Booker while you going. Fuck you talking about, bitch ass nigga.
Bitch ass,
fuck y'all doing.
Stop playing. Me ain't playing.
I'm Young Fresh though.
Man, he just real, you know what I'm saying? His music, just a real nigga, just, I fuck with him. You know what I'm saying? It's my brother, twin.
What did you smell of your shoe for?
Best designer, that's why.
King Von, you will truly be missed. And I pray that your family, if any of them watches my Messy Mondays, I'm sending you all love, strength, guidance, healing, understanding. I'm sending y'all that because you all deserve it. And I pray that you find peace. All right, y'all. So before we get started, I have to give a shout out to my friend, and that is Desi Dior.
Hey, bitch.
Thank you so much for having my post notifications on. You were the first to comment. And I just want to say, I see you supporting me. So now it's my time to support you. All right, boo. Thank you, friend.
Hey, bitch.
Now, it is the time that everybody has been waiting on, and that is the shit. The sugar, honey, iced tea. Because you girls love staying in some shit. First, the sugar, honey, iced tea, we have Nene the Doll and YBL Cyrus. So before I start, I just want to say, he ain't really been on Missy Monday in a long time, and I don't even know, what does she do? Hello, somebody. Anyway, but that ain't none of my business, but we gonna talk about it. So, anyway, she took to her Instagram story and she decided to post up about him. And what she said was, let's see how spiteful of a baby mama I can be. And I'm just like, why would she even say that about her baby daddy? Like, did he do something? All I be seeing him do was going on Instagram Live, doing all these quotes and stuff, talking about Jesus. And then he be saying, playing him the music, and gets me every now and then. I mean, I will never be a spiteful baby mama. So, I mean, if you're looking for a baby mama. I mean, oh my God, stop! So I'm just not getting what has made her mad. Maybe it could be when he posted this picture right here, like a knight in shining armor with the girl on the beach kissing us stuff. I don't know, you know, sometimes the baby mamas always come out when the baby daddy move on, child. So I don't know. I guess she wanted to be the one to ride on the stallion. I'm just saying, Anyway, so she went on and she wrote, money don't make you a father. Well, I mean, if he's giving the baby money and doing what he needs to be doing for the baby, from what I'm guessing, then what else does he need to do to be the father? He's supposed to take care of you? You're not his problem. See? Now, I'm not saying this is what's going on, but I'm just saying, she ain't complaining not about the money. She's complaining that money don't make you a father. So I guess she said, if she's just giving the baby money to say, here you go, be happy. Maybe she said she want him to spend time with the baby, be around the baby, show him what a father's supposed to do. Maybe that's what she's saying. If that's the case, then I do agree with her. I don't know what's really going on, but it will come out, child, trust and believe. So anyway, YK O'Connor went into what she was saying, honey, and this is what he had to say.
What people do for clout, money don't make you a father. All I can do is laugh. See, I'm not gonna bash you. I'm not gonna be evil like that. But you know I take care of my son though. And you know I'm a great father. But you know I ain't gonna do all that for, you know, like, it's not even worth it. But speak facts before you get on the ground, baby. Before you try to be famous. This here. I'm never gonna bash you. Cause you still Kingston mother. But don't get on the Instagram selling out about me. No damn well, I take care of my son. I'm a very good father. Don't do that.
So, I don't know what's really going on, you feel me? But, baby, just speak facts before you start talking about YKO. And, you know, YKO, if you ain't spending time with your son, you know what I'm saying? You got to do that. Spend time with your son, bruh. You feel me? So, speak facts. I guess why I keep waiting, because she ain't came back out and said nothing. He said what he had to say, and they left it at that. So, child, it is what it is. Well, if it ain't about me, spend time with your baby. Next case. Next to Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Money Gaga. Well, you bitchy. This little helper made sure she got pregnant. She trapped this man. She said, oh, if you don't want to be with me, you're going to have to deal with me. This thing right here. She is a whole lot of hard. I ain't never seen somebody so happy to be a single mother. Girl, I know you lying. I guess the ring makes her think she got a husband, but bitch, if you really want to be clear, he was just on the internet talking to Jania. Did you see what he said? Jania had wrote, if it wasn't for Savage Fenty, I never would have took lingerie photos. And then here go NBA Youngboy talking about, I just want to see you take your off. I'm like, oh my God, but when you just post up at Money Y'all Guys baby shower with your new soon-to-be son? Child, this is a whole lot, I don't know what to say. These girls just love saying, put me in, coach. Man, she just over here frolicking in the store, just so happy, showing the belly. We know you're pregnant. We knew you were pregnant when your friend tried to out you months ago. But anyway, she says, I just want to say I love you no matter what. You have a special place in my heart. Woo, 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 la, la, la. And then he goes and says, I love you too, Nene. Oh, girl, Nene. Anyway. So he said, I love you too, Nene. Thank you for everything. I'm sorry, girl. I don't think nobody gonna ever have the respect, love, and place that Nene got. Child, I don't see none of them girls having that. But y'all think she did it when she had this baby, honey. So, girl, it is what it is. So, went to the baby shower. He was there. It was a success. Woo, woo, woo. Girl, at this point, this is a whole daycare. Okay, well, I ain't got nothing to do with it, so I'm just leave it alone. Girl, if it ain't about me, let's kick it. Next case. Next to the Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Arlan and Izzy. Now, I'm gonna keep it real. Something about this situation seems real fishy. Because what I've learned is when a guy they try to do everything to make it seem like they are so innocent. Because I've noticed on Messy Monday, the men can be in the wrong so bad, but they get on here and act like it was all the woman. That's why they end up getting back together. Because trust me, when a woman do a guy wrong, they gon' leave. They don't ever turn back. I don't know why they don't say, they just don't. It's like, oh, you fucked up, you cheated, you did, goodbye. But when the man cheats, the woman always take them back for some weird reason. It's I don't know why it's like that. But okay, let's just get into it. I didn't see the tweets. I don't know what she said. Y'all just sent me his. But from what I'm reading off of his, she was subtweeting, saying something, thinking that he's cheating. I guess that's the story. And he caught wind of it. So this is what he had to say. Somebody was like, okay, so damn, this girl cooked for you, clean for you, love you unconditionally, deal with all them people in the house, and then you wanna break up with her. He said, I didn't break up with her. I don't want anyone else but her, and she knows that. Well, if you don't want nobody else but her, then why break up with her? And that doesn't make sense to me. That was the stupidest shit ever. But anyway, so then he goes on and says, I left because you start forgetting my work. And I never forgot yours, which is unfair. I do my part as a man. You let me down, gang. You know you did. I'm fucked up for real. To me, it just sounds like he's trying to manipulate her and make her think like what she did or what she's assuming is wrong. Because if this girl is cooking for you, cleaning for you, dealing with all these people in the house, how did she forget your worth and not make you feel good if she's doing all this stuff? Maybe she's honestly just tired. I done had your baby. I'm cooking. I'm cleaning. All these folks in the house. Sometimes I just need a break. And then I guess when you give a nigga a break, then child, you done forgot about him and his worth. And then he feel like you don't love me no more. And that gives him the ammunition to go and cheat. And then when you catch him cheating, then he want to call you out and say, it ain't nobody. It ain't never been nobody. Now, see, I don't know what's going on, but I'm just trying to see. So then he goes on and tweets some more in the journal. I'd rather be loved by no one than to be loved wrong by the one I love the most. Well, nigga, why did you put a baby in her hand? You didn't know all of this before you laid down and had this baby? I'm just trying to figure it out. If this girl didn't love you like you thought she did, why bring the baby into the situation? Oh, child, he fussing like him and his brother be fussing, honey. They gonna get right back together. This is just, why even fuss on the internet knowing y'all gonna go back together? That's just so stupid to me. That's just, let's keep reading the chart. Get off the internet playing victim, pump faking. I've been said I'm not talking to no other girl. I told that to Essence, she just wants attention. I'm shooting a music video. Where was all this love when I was begging you to be solid? Where was all this passion? You don't feel what I feel. Okay, but did you ask her how she felt? Maybe she was pulling away with her love because she felt you didn't love her. It's a difference between telling a girl, oh, be solid, be this, be that. But if you're always out shooting a music video or doing this or doing that, in her mind, she's thinking like, okay, so what is he doing? Is he cheating? What's going on? He's always out. I got the baby. It's just a whole lot of. So maybe her love felt gone too. So now she's pulling away. How about you talk about it? Period. Let's keep reading this journal. Everyone see when I left, but they ain't see when she was fucking me up mentally. And then get on here trying to discreetly sub me, but I'ma make this shit clear. Sweetie, you rambling. You doing a whole lot of, and really saying nothing. You just making it seem like you just upset because she ain't kissing your feet and making your plate. That's what it seemed like. I don't know, but whatever case it be, let's keep reading this journal. And ladies, if a motherfucker love you unconditionally, love him back. Bitch, I pushed out a whole baby for you. You don't think I love you? Hello, sir. Hello. hello. And I pushed the baby out and now I'm gonna have to be with it because you wanna break up me and go do your own thing now. I don't love you. You know what? At this point, I'm not the girlfriend, I'm your baby mama. Next! See, girl, that's why y'all gotta stop having these men babies without getting married and being together for at least 2 or 3 years and knowing if it's gonna really work out, because these boys, really be acting up when you don't act like they puppet or they pet or they do girl. This is not that. Hold on, let's keep going. So you just keep posting, talking about something. You need to tell people when they wrong and this and that. And woo. At this point, it's draining. I really believe he might've got caught doing something and she caught him out on it. Cause girl just ain't finna call you out on cheating unless she suspects you cheating and you've done it before and she caught you. So now her mental is fucked up. So now everything you do, she's gonna think you're cheating. So if that's the case, he needs to be apologizing to her and making her feel comfortable and secure as a woman. Like, I'm not gonna go anywhere. But if she can't let whatever happened in the past go, then they do need to leave because it's gonna keep causing friction. Then he gonna feel like she don't love him and she gonna be pulling away. He gonna think that she don't love him and he don't love her. It's just at this point, let it go. Throw it away. Throw the whole relationship away because it's a lie. They gonna fix it, like I said, like him and his brother do. They just love the bitch a little bit. You know, it's gonna be all right. But it is what it is. If it ain't about me, let's keep eating. Okay. Next with Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Chris Guy. Well, Chris said that he was gonna make a song explaining everything. So, child, this is what he had to say. Okay, Chris, first of all, why are you yelling and why is your voice sound like that? And second of all, popping perkies like they painkillers. Just say perks. Perky. I'm popping perkies like they painkillers. They out here labeling me like a gang member. Nigga, what? You're not a gang member, sir. I don't think anybody said that. Chris, relax, sweetie. Just say you want to be hard. If you want to be a thug, say you want to be a thug, Chris. I mean, it is what it is. Let's keep going. Baby, that way you shine it, go in the rain, hit you. I just got a little money, I'm still the same nigga. He got a little money, but he's still the same nigga. Well, just because you're the same nigga don't mean you gotta wear the same pants all the time. That's, I ain't said it, that's what Clarence said. But let's keep going. They wanna talk about abuse, let's talk about it. You got scarred from your past, so let's talk about it. I was young and insecure when I gave you them bruises. Chris, if you just want abuse, that's all you had to say. So, cause you could have easily just said, yes, I hit Queen before. That's all you had to say. You just wanted us to come to your channel, listen to your song, get you a little money, and it is what it is. That's what it was, Chris. Chris, you just, I try to be on your side, Chris. I try. But Chris, you just a whole lot. Chris. We're not gonna talk about it. We're gonna leave it alone. All right, well, hopefully this is the last time Chris mentioned Queen. You done said what you had to say. You done gave us the information. You made the song. It is what it is. Can we let it go? If you say anything now about Queen or Clarence, Chris, at this point, I'm gonna have to leave you alone and go be with them, because now I feel as though it might be a little clout chase, friend, because you done said everything you had to say. Everything's out in the open. You finally done talked to Clarence. You done talked to Queen. It's time to let it go, Chris. It's time to move on. Let that hurt go, friend. Let it go. Well, all right. So if it ain't about me, let's kiki. Next case. Next with the Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Ruby Rose and Gigi. Y'all, why do y'all take them serious? Like, bitch, y'all know you two couples break up for the weekend, so why are y'all taking them serious? I'm so tired of these two. Like, when y'all see them argue, let them argue. They are toxic, confused individuals who really don't even really like each other. They like attention. And when one of them don't get attention, they cry about it. Y'all, let them go. And to be honest, we gonna get there. Okay, so y'all remember last week, he on the internet crying, talking about he don't want to be with nobody and all this other stuff, and it's toxic, but because he loved her, that's why he was dealing with it. Girl.
And I want y'all to know, despite what I tweet, despite what I say, like, this is a person that I spent hours, days with. You know what I mean? Like, go to sleep, wake up. She stayed at my house for a long time. Like, you know what I mean? We're like a real actual relationship. You know what I mean? So I'm not going to sit up here and act like, you know, I ain't love her, or I didn't have feelings for her, or we wasn't really dating, blah, 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 this other shit. It's a lot of stuff that y'all don't see online that attracts me. You know what I mean? She's a different person online than offline, right? She's a very nice girl. Very, very nice. But just like myself, I'm not going to sit here and point the finger. She's damaged. I'm damaged as well. And, you know, niggas tried.
And then, just this week, he had a basketball game with Ruby. If you really ask me, child, she wasn't even there for him. She was there for the other YouTubers. Girl, she was collabing and networking. Hello? We gonna get a video about that next.
Well, while we were out at the basketball game, I come to find out Ruby switched numbers with somebody else. Now she's with them.
And then he gonna be crying for 2-3 days like an old woman, honey. And he gonna come back and say how much he loved her. They gonna be caked up on another day. I don't know why y'all be letting them troll y'all like this. To me, they're really not even together. It's another YouTube couple, like he said he did with the last girlfriend. They see how much money and drama they get from y'all, and they just milking it, girl. They don't even probably like each other. Ruby out here with some real hood nigga who digging her down. And y'all, she let her little sister, DDG, play with y'all. That's her sister, girl. That's her good Judy. That's her sister. They are partners. Partners. Money partners. Well, they back together for the 20th time. They will break up in 2 weeks. All right? Write it down and watch it. If it ain't about me, let's kiki. Next case. Next with Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Bobby Lights and Andre. It looks as though Bobby Lights will slide into the DMs, honey. She says she don't care if he a thief. So I hope Bobby Lights got all his stuff locked up. But that ain't none of my business. So from what everybody is seeing, Bobby Lights and Andre, which is Jeffree Star's ex-boyfriend, are together. They've been wooed up in Miami doing their thing and taking pictures and things like that. And everybody was asking Bobby, so, girl, why are you with him? And so he decided to come out, and this is what he said.
Okay, so it's really not anybody's business.
It's nobody's business, but you posted y'all's pictures being out on a date together. Obviously, you wanted it to be somebody's business, but that ain't none of my business. Let's let you talk about it.
But it is, because everyone makes it their business. So here this goes. You know, I do what I want to do whenever I want to do it. And as long as I'm not hurting nobody, I feel like it shouldn't press anybody and nobody should be concerned. As far as people trying to paint negative, you know, what about his baby mama? Okay, first of all, let me just say, me and Andre, we're cool. You know, we don't have a label on anything. And another thing about me is I'm a very respectful person. And I don't come to bring drama or I'm not a homewrecker.
Okay, Bobby, all that is fine and dandy, girl. But if you just wanted to dick after you saw it on his OnlyFans, just say that. I mean, that's all you got to say, girl. The dick looked good and you wanted it, sis. So now what we need to do is just prepare for Bobby and Andre's OnlyFans because they both got it. I'm sure they're going to collab. And bitch, when they drop it, they made one. That money is going to come in because the girls are going to watch it. Just say that, okay? We know you're not going to be with this man. You like Lil Nas, honey. Well, maybe you don't like him no more because he's supposed to move. Don't got a new boyfriend. I don't know, but just know this relationship is not real. It's a fuck thing, okay? So y'all don't get too happy about it. And this is no shade to nobody, but girl, I know what I see, okay? If it ain't about me, Bobby, go on, girl, and get you that D. Next case. Next on the Sugar Honey Iced Tea, we have Future and Des Dior. For those who don't know, Jada is Des' best friend. So she was having her birthday party at the club and people ended up spotting Future in the background. And if you didn't catch it, she had the AP on. Now I know what y'all remember Future said if you had the AP. Bitch, they know the guy. And if it really is official for the 2 months or 3 months they gonna be together, I will say, her and Jada bagged the hottest niggas in the game. Girl, I am so over it, child. Well, we gonna have to keep an eye on this Baywatch because, this is a, hold on. Girl, please keep them legs closed. Don't fall for the hype. Future, I think, Jesus. All right, well, if it ain't about me, let's geeky in the cat. All right, well, that's all I got for the Sugar Honey Iced Tea. Let's get into this mess. First look, okay, we have Trey versus Armand. Now, all I gotta say, child, is people get new teeth and don't know how to act. Hello. When folks had these braces, they weren't acting like that. Okay, so the brothers, they went on the social media, their Instagram stories, and they were letting each other have it. I'm just like, what is going on? And what I'm starting to think is, Armand is the problem. You lost two bids in one day. Hello now, your girl and then your brother. What is it? I feel the brother was probably trying to tell him how he was in the wrong on the internet doing all this and all that. And then Armand got mad. Armand secretly got anger problems, anger issues, and he don't know how to control it. So he just lash out and he's probably stubborn and real selfish and self-centered. But that ain't none of my business. Let's just talk about it. So Trey ended up on social media and he posted, y'all please make sure these motherfuckers y'all call family. Have y'all's best interests even if you're at your lowest. And ain't gonna steer y'all in the wrong direction. Ain't gonna actually keep it 100 with you no matter what the situation. So then here comes Miss Armand, honey, and her feelings real angry. And she says, I'm Armand. I'm not in a group or nothing. Sis, relax. Trey didn't even say that. All Trey said was just make sure the people you call your family steer you in the right direction no matter what. At your lowest, at your high, they're just there for you. So why did you go ahead and say, I'm not in a group. I'm not in nothing. Like, you just angry. You just mad. You just... The same way you walked away from Essence, the same way you walked away from your brother. Honey, you don't like to talk about nothing. You just like to walk away and be stubborn and want people to come kiss your feet. That's what I'm getting. So then, even after he says that, Trey comes back and he says, I love my people and I would never tell them anything wrong. I'ma always keep it 100 people if you're wrong or if you're right. And that's what makes me be like, see, he's trying to say, he feel like his brother probably effed up with the girl and you need to get yourself together. Let's keep reading. We need more real niggas like me in this world. And then here he come. Mind you, the brother Trey didn't say nothing rude, out the way. And then here comes Armand again, angry and mad. I'm all by myself on all 10. Fuck you, whoever. Fuck you. Wait a minute. I didn't say nothing to you. I didn't say nothing mad, mean, or out of the way, but you all by yourself. You're not in a group. Fuck me. Yeah. And then he comes back and says, I just want to take care of my baby. That's all. That's it. Legacy Dior, I know I ain't do shit. Go ask her. Fuck wrong with y'all niggas. I was 10 down for my family. Fuck a lie. What's up, Ten? Like, why is he talking like he's so hood? Like, nigga, you sing. You're an R&B singer. Like, relax. You had braces. Didn't he have braces? Jesus, he just so gangster for some reason. Might never see him fight nobody. But his brother. Tell him stop playing me before I turn into Superman. So after all the arguing, they then go and they follow each other. And I'm just like, didn't you just say in your song that you would ride for him, you would slide for him, y'all just had two kids, you would die for him?
If I call that man my brother, I'd ride for him. And we just had two kids, we'd die for him.
I guess that was a lie. All right. Well, if it ain't about me, Armand is F-A-K-E. Next K. Next up, Duckett, we have Kim Bun and Quando Rondo. So what this segment is about is just to keep people up on how it happened. I don't want to talk too much on it because the man has passed away and I just don't feel good talking about it. So what we're going to say is he was here in Atlanta and he was at Opium and he was doing a show. So after the show, apparently he got into an altercation with some of Quando Rondo's entourage and it turned into a fight. And here is where 600 Breezy is saying kind of how the fight was taking place.
So this really go for all the people who watch our culture and be trying to call Chicago niggas bitches for all the shooting we doing and not. Y'all clearly seen folks was putting hands on that nigga, beating the fuck out of him, like beating his ass. Von a skinny nigga. He really put hands on him and you see what happened. My first time ever getting shot at, it was from me breaking a nigga jaw. Niggas coming to my school every day trying to kill me over fist fights. My homie just got took out his glow over a fist fight. This whole generation fucked up. Niggas can't take ass whoopings. Niggas get their ass beat. Nigga come blowing. If Nick Folks them would have been blowing from the jump, if that was what it was, folks use hands. So that's all I'm saying. Everybody, I don't never want to hear niggas, Chicago niggas, bitches. They can't fight. All they want to do is shoot. Come on, you just think that folks won barely 160 pounds. Put them bitches on the nigga and his man's blue. Come on camera at that. Threw his life away. We lost folks. He throw his life away. You feel me? When they could have just took that ass whooping and been embarrassed on the internet and it could have been going from there.
So as you heard him saying, it started off with the fist. And you know, nowadays when people get upset with each other and you start getting your ass whooped, you want to pull out a gun because you feel like that's going to make you the ultimate alpha cat. But really that made you a pussy because you murdered somebody and then you lost your own life. You threw it away. So the guy who had shot him, nobody knew who he was at the time, but it was on cameras. I'm not showing that footage because I don't want to show it. He shot him and things happened. So people are saying, how did all this start? So allegedly back in August, Von had called Dex a sweet faggot ass nigga for crying after he had heard of the murder of another Chicago artist, which is FBG Duck. And I think that's when all the beef started happening and things started taking place. And then like 5 days ago, he kind of bumped heads with NBA Youngboy because NBA Youngboy Contrell had came out with this preview of him and Asian Doll song that's supposed to be coming out.
I was mad, but won't touch me.
Mind you, Asian Doll is King Bun's on and off girlfriend. And then remember King Bun a couple of months back had came out with a song with Jania, which is NBA Youngboy's baby mama.
I've been working. We have a song coming out. Y'all wasn't supposed to know, but it is what it is now. We have a song coming out.
So it's like they were playing tit for tat. And I'm like, oh my God. And why are the girls even getting involved knowing these men got these undercover beefs with each other? And it's just too much. A whole lot of. So that's just wrapping that up. Getting everybody where we at. And then Quando Rondo's friends with NBA. And, you know, just a whole lot of stuff. It's just a bunch of just mess. So back to the night of the opium. They were outside. The boys shot. And then people were trying to say it was the police officers who did it because they heard this recording, but really it wasn't. The police officer was just firing back. He was off duty because there were shots fired in the air, and he has to take, you know, sometimes you're under contract, you still have to protect the club. So anyway, once everybody learned that he passed away.
We don't want forever. You dig what I'm saying? Real deal, king of drill. I ain't never seen like Von. Everything he ever spoke in his theories was true. Everything you ever heard, they was true. Yeah, it's all good. RP, my, I love you.
It was just crazy. It was tragic. You had celebrities just posting and posting and posting. Dirk was on live when he found out. When Dirk found out on live, that's when 6ix9ine's messy ass came in there laughing. Not only did he just laugh, also went up under Dirk's page with laughing faces. This is sick. Now, I don't know if this is an edit, but allegedly this is really what he did. Then Dirk ended up deactivating his page. It's just a whole lot. This is just mess. Like, these people gotta stop gang violence. Y'all gotta stop glorifying guns and people killing each other and being hard or whatever the case may be. Woop, woop, woop. So, Asian Doll then took to her Twitter, you know, you're angry at this moment, you're sad at this moment, and she starts saying a lot of things. She said they didn't get shot or die with Bun, they didn't help him, y'all can't use him anymore to do what y'all needed him to do, because apparently, you know, allegedly, Bun was on go. He would do whatever he needed to do to handle you. And then she was just saying she would have died behind him or whatever the case may be. And she knows she's in a better place, but she just feel the people he was with were fake. She's like, how is this man getting shot at and y'all ain't busting back? He would have busted back for y'all. So one of his friends who was there who also got shot, he came out and he said, let one more person from the outside that's close to Bun say one more goofy shit. He's going to expose y'all. He don't care who it is. He goes for anybody and ex-girlfriends, girlfriends, whatever.
That is completely false. First of all, no disrespect to Asian Doll. And we spoke this morning because I seen some of the tweets and some of the stuff and I reached out to her. I'm like, hey, bro, I know you're mourning and you hurt like everybody else, but you need to slow down because one, you wasn't there. So how can you make assumption and accuse guys of doing this and that? And the last words that she's talking about, and it's in a text message and I can show you, she's talking to Vaughn through her spiritual advisor from after death.
Wait. So this is what she tweeted. She tweeted, Vaughn's last word was, y'all let them niggas get up on me. Stop crying. Y'all let them get me. As if Vaughn was talking to his homie saying,
hold on, Ag. I'm gonna show you right now. I got it right here.
You were speaking to Vaughn through your spiritual advisor. Then I come to the fucking office and sit down with you, gang. And y'all probably thought it was funny. Y'all probably was laughing at my pain, laughing at the situation I was in. And guess what you did? You spit me. You ain't even say nothing back, gang. We was cool. I came to this gang and asked you, like, I came to you. Stop playing. I'm at the end of the day, gang. I'm Asian Doll, and that's just period.
What? Just keep breathing, cuz.
Hold on, you can't move on that.
You got
bro.
It. My fault.
Yeah.
Ma'am, he's shot. What you mean, wrong side? Come on. Okay. Please, come on. All right.
Okay.
Well, get him a wheelchair.
It's just sad to see King Von go when his career was getting ready to. It was finally like taking off. Like he had songs, he was good, people knew him, but it was getting to that level where he was going to be like, okay, this is going to be a hot one to fuck with. But it's just so sad. So then in the midst of all that, y'all know with him and NBA YoungBoy having what they got going on, NBA then comes out of nowhere because you know he's been taking a break from the internet because he battles with, I guess, depression and things he's going with. And this is what he had to say.
Still in a dark place inside my life. I'm still hurting, but I'm still always praying though. And even though it's getting ugly, I'm still getting it on. I'm letting y'all know I love y'all and I'm good. No need to worry about me at all.
I don't know if that had to do with anything that happened last week, but it just seems as though something is taking a toll on him. You know, sometimes you can come off as this rude, disrespectful, crazy guy, but you really do have a heart for people. So I don't know. It's just sad. So yeah, that's all I want to say about the situation. I'm not going to talk bad on nobody or talk real down in it because, you know, it's a sensitive topic and it's a lot going on, but I just feel like I just don't feel like none of this is over. I feel like it's gonna get messy. So we're just gonna keep our eyes on it and it is what it is. If it ain't about me, let's keep keeping this case. Alright, now y'all gonna be mad, but there really isn't anything else to talk about. It was all the political stuff going on last week with the voting. So I guess people were like really focused on getting people out to vote. So there's really talk about. Y'all gonna be like, Messy Monday over. And then Chris Styles, y'all know he done met up with Leslie, which is Clarence's ex-girlfriend. Ain't that her name? But yeah, And they talking about they're gonna do a YouTube video together, which should be very interesting. And there wasn't really a lot of stuff that went down like that besides Future lying about, you know, going to court, saying he'll live in a two-bedroom house and really didn't have all this money to pay for child support. Child, stop trying to keep your money and go pay for your kids, period. That's all, but I really ain't got too much to say. Well, that's all I got for Messy Monday. I will see y'all next week. Y'all stay messy, be messy, because without y'all, there will be no Messy Monday. Follow my Instagram and Twitter. I know y'all cussing me out, but guess what? I don't care no fuck. If the girls weren't messy, they weren't messy, period. If it ain't about me, let's get key next game.
Messy Monday. It's a whole lot going on. It's a whole lot going on. It's a whole lot going on. It's a whole lot going on.